Hello, I'm Barbara Ray. I'm here in our London office and had the pleasure of talking with Maya Leibman today, former CIO of American Airlines and now strategic advisor to American Airlines. And we talked about the pace of change and transformation coming at the office of the CIO.
I'm Maya Leibman. I have had a long career with American Airlines. For the last 10 years, I was the CIO responsible for the technology organization. And for the past year, I have done a role here in London as a senior advisor.
Was the work that you did kind of connected to the evolution of the organization and the business?
Absolutely. Pretty much everything we did was around this transformation journey. And it wasn't just sort of how American interacts with our customers and how we interact with, you know, the ecosystem that we exist in, but also how technology itself is changing and how we needed to change not just what we did, but how we did it. Yeah.
So how did the role of the CIO change with regard to that transformation?
So the CIO role and the role of technology has always been really important. That said, you know, just with this explosion in the last 10 years of consumer electronics and the things that we can now do as consumers, you know, from our phones, that put a lot more pressure on the airlines that were probably a little bit behind that curve to say, okay, I can do all these things. Now I want to be able to do it with my airline as well.
So when you think about the employees of American, both inside and outside of technology, how has this significant change pivoted what they're doing, and how have they either have or have not sort of come along for that journey?
Yeah, employees have to differing degrees sort of bought into this transformation and the changes and have come along for the journey. Yeah. What I think we realized was that you know, there's no real strategic competitive advantage in what we do. So if we develop a better way for you to track your bags, another airline could easily copy that. You know, right. They may be a month or two behind or something like that. But what we do is not a sustainable strategic competitive advantage. But if we can get better at how we do things, if we can work through that endless to-do list more quickly because of the tools and the processes and the mindset and the culture and all of these things together, that's a true sustainable competitive advantage.
But if you had to give advice to an executive who was getting ready to launch into something new, transforming something, moving to whatever it might be, what would be the three things you say, if you miss these, you're missing it?
I'd say number one, just how much you need to communicate. You know, you sort of think, oh, I say it once and then everything's fine. We're all gonna go do it. But I think you gotta say something 10 times for people to actually listen and absorb it, and then probably another 10 or 20 times for them to believe it,
right,
and to be bought in. So I think communicate, over communicate, that sort of thing. That'd be number one. Number two would be, you know, you want to bring the willing and, you know, get people bought in and get things moving, and then sort of worry about the detractors later. I think the people want to be part of it. They don't want things done to them. So do it with them. And in large part, that helps to do it with those who are sort of willing and bought in initially. And then third, you know, I think it's, you know, everyone says, oh, it's a journey, not a destination. And I think I didn't really appreciate that. Oh, yeah, of course. Yeah, that sounds good. You know, but I think I sort of felt like, oh, well, at some point we're going to be done, right? And then I think over time I realized, oh, no, there's really no end to this. You can always continue to get better.
Yeah. Thank you so much for being here, Maya.
My pleasure. Thank you for having me.
Absolutely.